welcome. Happy 25th anniversary. Let's all stand up. Can you greet the person beside you? Happy anniversary. Glad to see you here. This is a big reunion of sorts. We have several congregations represented here, but later on we're going to do that. But today we're going to focus our attention to the one who planted this church, the one who established, the one who's building this church. And he's no other than our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We will give praise to our God. The God has been faithful to us for the past 25 years. In Psalm 36 verse 5, the Bible says, "Your steadfast love, O Lord, extends to the heavens, your faithfulness to the clouds." And we are celebrating God's faithfulness to us, His church. And how many of you feel the love of God for you right now? God's steadfast love, it reaches the heavens. It touches the earth. It affects all of us. In fact, God's character, His steadfast love, moves Him to keep His word, and that is His faithfulness. And I believe that there's not one that should receive the honor today that is only God Himself. Amen. No person, no church, no group, only God Himself receives all the glory. Amen. We're going to focus our attention on the Lord. Father, thank you so much for your faithfulness upon your church this past 25 years. And we celebrate not our accomplishment, but we celebrate your goodness. We celebrate your hand. We celebrate your love. We celebrate your faithfulness. We celebrate who you are in our lives. Not to us, O Lord, but to you be the glory, God, because you are love. You are faithful, God, to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's all worship the Lord right now. Come on.
I will go where you would go. your power and glory, defeated the enemy. Lord, you are great.
Faithfulness. Kung feeling mo nakukulangan ka, just look around you. Someone out here has a story for you that will remind you of His goodness. And this is the beauty of church. Not the four walls that God's been building. It's you and me. It's you and me. This is the church. It can be 50. It can be 200 in Westgate. It can be 2,000 here. But this is God's church. So we're going to declare We're going to worship. You can give Him praise. You deserve this praise, God. You deserve this praise. You deserve this worship. Oh, you deserve our praise. You deserve our worship. You deserve our praise. You deserve our worship. You deserve it, God. We, your people, oh, together bring you honor, give you reverence. By your spirit, you have chosen people, sons and daughters. We declare it. Whose church is this? Come on. This is. This is your church, God building. Jesus, cornerstone, God church, God building. This is your church, God building. Jesus, cornerstone. Kami sa'yo, O Kristo. Kami sa'yo, O Kristo. Kami sa'yo. Kami sa'yo, Kristo. Panginoon, aming Diyos, O Kristo.
The beginning, we are founded in your love. All of your promises hold true, and for your purpose, whatever it takes, we will endure. Even through darkness, we'll break through. Faithful then, faithful now. Faithful always, for from you and through you, for from you are all things, and through you are all things. You're the Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end. Oh, glory and honor, dominion and power belong to you. We worship you. Through every season, Lord, you give and take away, but by your grace we worship.
So we will trust you, God.
So we will trust you, knowing that you are in control. Lord, I know you are so.
We will glorify your name.
Yours is the kingdom. All of the earth belongs to you. Wherever you send us, we will go. Till every tribe, every nation, fill the earth with adoration. Bow down to go.
Give it all you got. Declare this. Say, faith.
Let it sink in, the faithfulness of God to us, His people. Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to Your name give glory for the sake of Your steadfast love and Your faithfulness. I was reminded of the story of Moses when he was really asking, Lord, Lord, I want to see Your glory. Introduce Yourself to me. And in Exodus chapter 34, God actually gave in and He said, okay, I'm going to introduce Myself to you. Exodus 34 verse 6 says, the Lord passed before him and proclaimed, and this is how the Lord introduced Himself to Moses. The Lord, a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness, keeping steadfast love for thousands, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin, but will those will by no means clear the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers on the children and the children's children, to only to the third and the fourth generation. God introduced himself to Moses not on the basis of what he can do, but on the very basis of who he is, his very nature, that he is love. He is abounding in loving kindness. He is God who is known as a faithful God, compassionate, forgiving those and giving favor. And he said, I will give favor and love extended to 1,000 generations. He is known as faithful. Amen. He is known as the God of love. He is known as the one who will never change. In fact, if we become faithless, how many of you know that God will remain faithful to us? That is the very nature of God. He will never change. Faithful then, faithful now, faithful always, up to 1,000 generations. In fact, God is faithful to us in this generation. We've seen the pandemic. We've seen how we have struggled. We've seen how we've gone through some difficult times. And how many of you know God's hand sustained us all these years, and he will continue to sustain us in many more years, up to 1,000 generations. Your children, your children's children, the children after those are safe because God's love will prevail. God's faithfulness is true for them as well. Amen. He will be faithful for his promises. And there's a reason why we worship the Lord. Not because of something that we can get from him. Not because of his hand, but because of his face, because of his very nature, because of his heart, because he is a faithful God. He is a benevolent God. You know, when you see that pairing of his steadfast love and his faithfulness, when you see that paired in the book of Psalms, it speaks of God's benevolence. It speaks of God's care and love for his people. And I believe that that is seen already in this church, in your personal lives, in our families. Amen. Let's give the Lord once again a praise. Thank you, Father. Let's continue to just worship. Can we just declare that again? I feel it. Let's declare once again the faithfulness of God upon our lives, upon this nation. I mean, God is faithful in this nation. Amen. Let's sing that song again.
Faithful then, faithful then.
Declare that over your life. Come on, make it a declaration of your life.
Faithful then.
Start thinking about your families right now and say, faithful then,
faithful then, faithful now.
Think about your situation right now. If you feel like it's tough, declare it.
Faithful then, faithful now, faithful always.
Sing it again for the last time.
Faithful.
Let's lift up our hands to the Lord. Oh, Father, you are an amazing God. We dare not even step into the spotlight of your glory. Your glory is your goodness. You have been faithful to your church. You have been faithful to your words. You have been faithful to your covenant for your people, God. And one day, Jesus is also coming back, and he will return with this, this sash written upon his thigh, faithful and true, because you are faithful and true to your church. Father, we thank you. This is us, your church, your bride. Help us to continue to honor you all the days of our lives. And may we as a people be faithful to you, our bridegroom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Well, good afternoon, everyone. before you sit down, would you kindly just meet the person beside you? If you haven't known them or haven't introduced yourself, go ahead and introduce yourself to at least 3 or 4 new faces, okay? Let's not be in a hurry. Okay lang yan, okay? Take the time. Let's open the house lights. Take the time to meet those people from the other churches, from the other congregations. This is like a big reunion of sorts. We see here different congregations represented. All right, let's all settle down. Why'd you find your seats? How many of you are glad that you're here this afternoon? Come on now. Woohoo! Welcome to our 25th anniversary. 25 years. And how many of you that God will continue to do and be faithful for us for the next 25 years and beyond? That is who He is. And we are, you know, we have here a diverse set of people represented in this place from different generations. We have the boomers. How many of you are part of the boomer generation? Woohoo! Ayaw umamin. Okay lang yan. How many of you are part of the Gen X generation? The 80s, baby. Woo! How many of you are millennials? Millennial generation, we love you! And how many of you are Gen Z? Some multi-generation church. We love different ages. We love the next generation. We love our current generation as well. We also would like to acknowledge some of our victory churches that join us today coming out from Victory Alabang. We've planted out several churches. We'd like to welcome some of those of you from Victory Santa Rosa. If you are here, can we just welcome them? Can we give them a hand? Pastor John Naron is leading that. I see Pastor John, Pastor Carlo. If you are from Victory Parañaque, please be acknowledged. Stand up, Pastor JR. Are you here? Let's welcome them. All right. If you're from Victory Las Piñas, Victory Las Piñas, Victory LP. Woohoo! Go, Pastor Sani and Malu. Pastor Edre, I see you. And from our brand new church in San Pedro, Laguna. Where are you guys? Go and shout if you're from Victory San Pedro. Woohoo! Pastor King and Phoebe, that's our brand new church plant. And if you are also a senior pastor from other congregations of Metro Manila, in Metro Manila, we are one church, multiple congregation. And we would like to welcome you and acknowledge you. If you are a senior pastor or you are a wife, please stand up so that we can acknowledge you. Can we just welcome our dear senior pastor from the different parts of our metro? Pastor Noel, Pastor CJ, Pastor Tito, Pastor Nixon, Pastor Irwin, Pastor Chris, Pastor... Okay. Kasama pa rin si Pastor Edre. And if you are a government official from this city, we'd like to welcome you and acknowledge you. Thank you so much for coming. Can you please stand up if you are here, you're a government official. I see Cap Allen here and Malu. Okay, we might be joined later on by our dear mayor. Okay, thank you so much for coming and joining our celebration. Old members, you know who you are. Please give a hand to all of those who were here from day one, 1998. Of course, we see our founder, our dear pastor who planted this church. Founder, okay. The one who planted this church, Pastor Jojo and Ida. Of course, we're going to acknowledge them later on. Our dear executive team of Metro Manila, if you are here, can please stand up to be acknowledged. I see Pastor Michael Paderes. Okay, may Pastor John Delore. Of course, Bishop Gilbert is part of that. And part of our Bishop's Council, okay? Pastor Gilbert is also going to be speaking later on. Allow me to just introduce to you our speaker. And then later on, we're going to be looking at the past. But it's an awesome privilege for us to be able to celebrate not just 25 years of Victory Alabang, but we are going to celebrate next year. It's the 40th anniversary of Victory in the Philippines. Amen. That in 1984, God has called, you know, the other foreign missionaries led by Pastor Stephen Rice Brooks to plant a church here. And the one leading the charge right now is our very own BOM, Bomb. We call him the Bomb, okay? Bishop of Metro Manila. And allow me to just give a proper introduction to our dear Bishop, Bishop Gilbert Foliente. His passion and commitment has always been to disciple the next generation. He graduated from UPLB, UP Los Baños, and he was called to full-time ministry to pastor the church in Victory Los Baños at just the young age of 22 years old. Wow. In fact, he loved the church so much, he stayed there for a while. I don't know how many years before you graduated. And after this, he became the senior pastor of Victory UBL for about 11 years. He's happily married to his wife, Kathy, for almost 30 years. And they have two beautiful children, Alex and Alonzo. Let's give a warm Victory welcome, okay, to my friend, Bishop Gilbert Foliente.
Thank you, Pastor A.
Bagets na bagets talaga to.
Salamat, Pastor Hill. Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of our Bishop's Council and all our senior pastors, I want to greet every one of you. Happy 25th anniversary. Wow, 25! How many of you remember 25 years ago? Saan pa tayo nag-start noon, Pastor Jojo? Sa bago mag-Westgate. Yeah, nasa mausoleum. How many of you saw the lobby? You saw the lobby, you took pictures at the lobby 25 years ago. That's a long time. If you think of 25 years ago and try to remember ano pa yung meron ng 25 years ago, makikita natin marami nang nagbago. Okay, so many things have changed. 25 years ago, Google was founded. Okay, hindi pa natin alam ang Google. 25 years ago, inintroduce yung Google. And then, the first Apple iMac came out 25 years ago. Meron ba sa inyo nagkaroon ng ganitong iMac? And then, pretty much everyone during that time had a phone like this. Yan. Sino sa inyo may ganitong phone 25 years ago? Pwede mo rin pamukpok yan, di ba? Parang... And then, the huge thing during that time, the thing during that time was MP3 players. Wala pang iPod. Kasi 2001 pa nagka-iPod. The way you watch movies was when you try to rent. How many of you remember this? Tingnan natin. Okay, you remember this. VHS. The one who dominated the Oscars was Titanic 25 years ago. NSYNC erupted on the scene with the song, I Want You Back. Kaya mo ba yon, Pastor King? I Want You Back. And the ladies were still trying to rock the Rachel haircut during that time. That's a long time ago. And if you ever think of longevity, you can never, ever not think about faithfulness. 25 years is a long time for us to be doing church. And I want to honor, before we go into the Word, the people who've been faithfully serving God and the people of God. Of course, I want to honor Pastor Jojo and Ida. Pastor Jojo and Ida, it has been in their hearts to plant a church here, the city here, the people here. They obeyed God and they love the city. Thank you, Pastor Jojo and Ida, for laboring and serving for so many years. And of course, Pastor Ariel and Shirley, our longest serving senior pastors in one congregation. Arang kami lahat na mumove na mumove. Sila nandito, the man who cannot be moved. Hindi ma-move. But finally, and again, so many things, so many stories. Sabi nga ni Jose, Quest Jose Tantan. Sabi nga ni Jose kanina, it's stories that really make it special. And so many stories in this church. they've been a part of, and they led through those amazing stories. And of course, we just did a transition this year, welcoming Pastor Jansen and Ging. I want to honor Pastor Jansen and Ging for faithfully serving as a volunteer, as an admin staff, as one of the pastors, then Alabang, sending to Santa Rosa, served there, and then in Metro Manila, Bishop Ferdy said, come serve us in Metro Manila. He served there, and whatever we ask of Pastor Jansen, he always says, yes, that's what faithfulness is about. So Pastor Jansen and Ging, thank you for your faithfulness to serve. I want to honor all of our pastors and all of our missionaries and campus missionaries who have served in Alabang for the past 25 years. If that's you, can you just stand? Kung part ka noon, naging pastor ka dito. Pastors ngayon, even pastors ngayon, can you stand up? All of our pastors, all of our admin staff, all of our campus missionaries, all of our cross-cultural missionaries, thank you for faithfully serving the Lord. Thank you for all your sacrifices. And of course, I want to thank all of the leaders and all of the volunteers. If you're a leader, if you used to lead a victory group, if you're a volunteer, pwede ba tumayo kayo lahat? Tayo kayo lahat? Come on, we just want to honor you and say, without you, this church will not be here. Without you, our pastors will not be able to do what God has called them to do. Maraming maraming salamat sa inyong lahat. All right, thank you. But as great as it is for us to acknowledge, to appreciate and thank the faithfulness of the people who've served, there is no one greater than the God that we're going to celebrate today. God is faithful. Amen. We are celebrating the faithfulness of God. Allow me to read in Lamentations chapter 3, verse 21 to 23. Just a few verses. Lamentations chapter 3, verse 21 to 23. But this I call to mind, and I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. This is the word of the Lord. Lord, thank you that your faithfulness is great. Thank you for your word. I pray that your word would breathe life unto us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, if you look at Jeremiah was an author of three books in the Bible. First book that he wrote was the Kings. And the Kings, it was all about the nation of Israel's history. And then he wrote the book of Jeremiah. And Jeremiah, it was about God and his message to his people. So it was about the nation and its history. Jeremiah was about God and his message. But Lamentations was authored by Jeremiah as well. And this was about him and his feelings and emotions and perspective. All of them are inspired by God and the Holy Spirit, but very different perspectives. The nation's history, God's message, and Jeremiah's sentiment. During the time that he wrote Lamentations, his sentiment, the nation of Israel has lost everything. They have been forced to be exiled to Babylon, and for many of us, we know that Babylon was a very violent nation led by a brutal dictator, King Nebuchadnezzar. And the nation of Israel was in a dark place. The nation of Israel was not in a good place. And yet, right smack in the middle of the book of Lamentations, right smack in the middle of the chapter of the middle of the book, Jeremiah had the audacity. Jeremiah had this boldness to declare, great is God's faithfulness. Why? What does it mean when he says great is God's faithfulness? And what does it mean when we say great is God's faithfulness, as we've sung over and over a while ago? Here's what it means. Two things it means. Number one, it means God is faithful in every situation. If you look at the Bible, we all know that the Bible was written in Hebrew, and in Greek. And there are four major Hebrew words that were used in the Old Testament that's translated differently in English, and yet they all talk about faithfulness. Specifically, the faithfulness of God. There's one in the Greek, but four in the Old Testament Hebrew. When Jeremiah said, "Great is God's faithfulness," the Hebrew word for faithfulness was emunah, which conveys the concept of being steady. How many of you know people who are steady? Yung steady lang, diba? Hindi masyadong up, hindi masyadong, yung hindi nagbabago. Pagka masaya, yung mukha niya ganito. Pagka malungkot, yung mukha niya ganito. Pag natatakot, mukha niya ganito. Pagka gulat na gulat, mukha niya ganito. Steady. May mga kilala ba kayong gano'n? Meron kaming pastor's wife na kilala gano'n eh. We love that. Steady. And the first mention of this word was in Exodus chapter 17. And if you're familiar with Exodus chapter 13, this was when the Israelites were fighting a war against Amalekites. And Moses was there, and they said, Moses will intercede for Israel. How many of you remember that? And as he was interceding and as he was lifting up his hands, the Israelites were winning, but when he would lower down his hands, the Israelites would lose. So what did they do? In here's what they said in chapter 17 of Exodus, verse 12. But Moses' hands grew weary, so they took a stone and put it under him. And he sat on it, while Aaron and Hur held up his hands on one side and the other on the other side, so his hands were steady. That word steady conveys the concept of faithfulness. So it's interesting that the word faithfulness, emunah, in Lamentation was the same word. If you picture God and His faithfulness, imagine God raising up His hands. And every time He's raising up His hands, you're winning in life. You're winning every battle that you face. And the Bible says, He never grows weary. The faithfulness of God and the picture is this. It's a God who doesn't grow weary. It's a God who doesn't quit and gives up on you. It's a God who doesn't change. When we talk about the faithfulness of God, it is closely connected to the immutability of God. Nothing that God has ever said about Himself will ever be modified, and nothing that God has ever promised will be rescinded, because God is unchanging and God is unchangeable. With the so many changes that we've experienced, iba, ang daming nagbabago. Tapos naghahanap ka ng isang secure thing na hindi magbabago, I want you to know God is faithful. That way, He never changes. We can always use the word always to express this truth about God. Name me an attribute of God. Shout an attribute of God. I mean, think about an attribute of God. Good, loving, merciful, gracious, generous, forgiving. All of those attributes, you can always be certain that there are no sometimes attributes of God. All of God's attributes are always attributes. Always good, always loving, always merciful, always generous, always powerful, always gracious. That's why I love the song we were singing ago. God is good all the time, because it is always. Whatever attribute of God you can think of, it is an always attribute. Therefore, He is trustworthy. And that's what the notion of faithfulness is all about. Jeremiah's hope in the midst of pain, in the midst of suffering, in the midst of misery, in the midst of injustice and darkness, he said, the steadfast love of the Lord. How many of you are glad we have the steadfast love of God? Not only that, he said, His mercies. So he was talking about the attributes of God, and then he said, they're new every morning. He is still loving, He is still merciful, He is still steady, He has not changed no matter what the situation is. When the situation is good, God is good. When the situation is bad, God is still good. When the situation is impossible, God is powerful. When the situation is easy, God is still powerful. And this is the reason why Jeremiah in 29:11 was able to say this, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope in the future." We love this. We claim this. How many of you have ever claimed this promise from God? But he was prophesying this at a time of the darkest in their nation's history. And Jeremiah was able to declare the promise of God. They were in a different location. They were now in Babylon. They were facing a different situation. They were in a different season. Yet God's faithfulness to fulfill his promises and his plans has not changed. What does that mean for us? For us, it means this. 25 years ago, buildings have changed. Locations have changed. Technologies have changed. Presidents have come and go and have changed. Looks have changed. May katabi ka ba nagbago yung looks nila? Lalong pumogi, lalong gumanda. Pero si Lord, steady pa rin. Si Lord, hindi napapagod. Si Lord, hindi natutulog. Si Lord, hindi sumusuko. Si Lord, hindi nagbabago ng isip. God has not changed. God's faithfulness remains. Amen? And this is why we believe the plans and the promises for God in your life is still true. And the plans and the promises of God for Victor Alabang is still true. He promised in Matthew 16, he will build his church, and that is an unstoppable building. He will continue to build the church in Alabang no matter what changes come. He will build the church. The gates of Hades can't overcome the church. Disciples will be made, leaders will be raised, churches will be planted, missionaries will be sent out to campuses and nations will be reached. Why? Because God is faithful in every situation. And no matter what situation in life you face, He will never change. He's still faithful. Second meaning, when you say God, great is His faithfulness, it means God is faithful in every generation. The word great, the adjective great, literally means great in quantity, great in number, plenty, many, numerous, multitude, great quantity. So pag inisip mo yung faithfulness na God, parang pwede mong bilangin. Pero hindi mo pwede bilangin kasi hindi na uubos. How many of you have ever felt generous before? And then sabi mo, ako naman lilibre sa'yo. Tapos pagdating niya, kasama pala yung buong pamilya. Tapos yung barangay kasama, sinisip mo magka-credit card ako. Credit card, binayaran mo. Tapos binalik ng waiter yung credit card mo. Wala pang nangyaring ganun sa inyo, no? Yung binalik. Kasi may limit yung credit card mo. Naubos yung limit. And sometimes that feels so disappointing, isn't it? When we feel helpless because we're limited. My wife is about to be discharged in the hospital, and she was in a surgery that was about to take 2 to 3 hours, but it took longer, 8.5 hours. Habang naghihintay ako, isip ko, ano kayo nangyayari sa kanya? And I felt helpless because my power is limited. But how many of you know that God's faithfulness doesn't run out after 3 hours? How many of you are glad that God's faithfulness doesn't run out when your credit limit runs out? How many of you are glad that God's faithfulness doesn't run out when your power runs out? When you run out of people you can run to, God's faithfulness never runs out. His faithfulness is infinitely great, and you can never, ever, ever consume it it is without end. If you look at the world's economy, they talk about the pie chart. Laging ganyan. Sabi nila, pinakamalaking economy, US, tapos yung China. Pag tiningnan mo yan, eh, iniisip mo, the wealth of the world, nasa US and China na. Paano na kami? Kasi limited yung wealth ng world. That's what economists would say. And if you think about the Philippines' wealth pie chart, ba, pag tiningnan mo, oy, naki Dennis C, Kathy Tan, Marquez, Morados, ang lalaki ng kanila, wala nang matitira sa akin. When you think about the faithfulness of God is not contained in a pie chart, it is unlimited. It's not like faithful si God sa iyo, paano sa akin? God can be faithful to every one of us, and not just to every one of us, to every generation, to every nation, to every people, and to every people group, because His faithfulness is great. It doesn't end with one country. God can be faithful to Israel. God can be faithful to Palestine. God can be faithful to the Philippines. God can be faithful to China. It doesn't run out with one family. And it's certainly great enough to be experienced and enjoyed by every generation. That's why in Psalm 100 verse 5, the psalmist declared, "For the Lord is what? Good. His steadfast love endures forever, and His faithfulness to all generations." And this is the reason why He is the God of Abraham, but not only the God of Abraham, He's the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, and the God of Joseph, because His faithfulness never runs out. Hindi lang pa isang generation. The faithfulness of God is in the generation of Pastor Steve. Yes. It's in the generation of Pastor Jojo and E that we've seen that. It's in the generation of Pastor Ariel and now with Pastor Jansen. But it's also in the generation of Bodhi and John Depp. The same presence of God, the same power of God, the same provision, the same growth, the same, all of this can be passed on to the next generation. Not because we're so good. Not because we've figured it all out, but because God is faithful and His faithfulness runs through all generations. He is the God of Ariel, He's the God of Anna, He's the God of Ewan, He's the God of Nathan III, 100 years from now. He's the God of our children's children and children that are yet to be born. He is faithful through all generations. Great is your faithfulness. And if you're a parent and you're thinking, how about my kids and my grandkids? His faithfulness never runs out. It goes through all generations. Now let me end by this. In verse 21, before he declared the faithfulness of God, he said this, "But this I call to mind." This I call to mind literally means this I remember. Jeremiah was trying to remember in the midst of pain, in the midst of misery, in the midst of suffering, he was trying to remember the faithfulness of God because his hope is in the faithfulness of God. But if you look at another Hebrew word that's used for the word faithfulness and associated with that, it's the word zakar, which is commonly used with the word remember. So when we think about God's faithfulness, it doesn't mean just giving a picture of steady, yes, but it also gives a picture of God remembering. And it's not because God has forgotten. It's not because God needs reminder. When he talks about God's faithfulness, it highlights God and what he is going to do whenever he is, quote-unquote, remembering. When God remembers his covenant, for example, he remembers. and His faithfulness kicks in. When God remembers His promise to you, His people, that thing kicks in, His faithfulness kicks in. And the first word, that word was used, first mention of the word Zakar, is in Genesis chapter 8, verse 1. It says, but God remembered Noah. But before chapter 8, the end of chapter 7 was pretty bleak. It says in verse 24, and the waters prevailed on the earth 150 days. Ang end ng chapter, ang nag-prevail yung flood. How many of you sometimes feel this way in your life? Nag-end, ang nag-prevail yung suffering, ang nag-prevail yung challenge, ang nag-prevail yung flood, ang nag-prevail yung sin, and you seem like, Lord, what's happening? But it doesn't end with that bleak picture because chapter 8 comes. And in verse 1, it says, but God remembered. Turn to your neighbor, tell them, but God remembered. The hopeless despair ending chapter 7 was met by God's remembering. And when God remembered, His faithfulness kicked in and the whole humanity was saved. God is faithful. He remembers. And every time you are faced with a bleak picture and a bleak future, I want you to know God remembers. And when He does, His faithfulness kicks in. Great is Thy faithfulness. Amen? Let's all stand and let's declare that. And we all bow our heads and close our eyes. Before we celebrate, I want to pray for some of you. If you are facing a bleak situation, maybe it's a sickness, maybe whatever that is, it might be finances. And it seems like there is little hope. I want you to know that in God's faithfulness, there's no room for despair. I want to pray for you. If that's you, can you just lift up your hand? If you're facing some bleak challenges, bleak future, you feel like it's dark and so many hands are raised. I want to pray for you. Raise both your hands to the Lord. Lord, thank you that you are faithful. And not only are you faithful, Lord, we're declaring Jeremiah in the midst of suffering, in the midst of misery, in the midst of hopelessness and pain. Lord, we're declaring in Genesis chapter 7, verse 24, when it seemed like the flood prevailed, we declare, but God is faithful, but God remembers, but God is always powerful, God is always loving. So Lord, today we rebuke any form of despair, and we infuse hope once more. That like Jeremiah, we will call to mind the faithfulness of God. In the name of Jesus, amen. Let's all lift our hands. Lord, for those of us who are in a great situation, there's no fear. There's no fear na baka mawala to. Baka mawala yung blessing. Baka mawala na yung godliness sa pamilya. Baka ano mangyari sa future. Baka hindi nila ituloy. There's no room for fear. Because God's faithfulness endures through all generations. No matter what happens around us, no matter what happens in our society, no matter what happens in the world, we're declaring no fear. Because God, your faithfulness is great. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody say, amen. Thank you.
Can we just declare this once again? Faithful then, faithful now.
Faithful then, faithful now. Faithful always. Faithful then, faithful then. Faithful now, faithful. Magbabago, faithful then,
faithful then,
faithful now,
faithful now.
things, and through you are all things. You're the Alpha and Omega. All glory.
God is good. Amen. God is good even when life seems bad. Sometimes we confuse God with life. Sometimes when things in life go bad, we accuse that that is a work of God. But how many of you know that God is not robbing anything from us? It's the devil who's robbing from us. In fact, in the same verse, in the same chapter that Jeremiah, Pastor Gilbert has alluded to, in Jeremiah chapter 3, in Lamentations chapter 3, it says in verse 17, I have been deprived of peace. Jeremiah was saying that, I have been deprived of peace. I have forgotten what prosperity is. And he was basically referring to what he's going through as a people, as a nation. And sometimes you can actually look at God as God's the one robbing from us. How many of you know that that's not the nature of God? It is the devil robbing us of peace, not God. God will always remain faithful. God is good even when life seems bad. Amen. And His nature will never change. And you've got to believe that. You've got to actually receive that even right now. In fact, I want to just pray for us, those of us who are believing, maybe for the longest time. Maybe it's a miracle you're crying out to, Lord, ang tagal naman. Sometimes I feel like, Lord, walang solution. But yet, God wants to stand with us. If you are that person, would you kind of lift up your hand? If there's anything, maybe in your family, in your life, maybe it's in your health, it's in your finances, maybe it's mental health. I don't know what you're going through, but God knows, and He wants to step in if you will allow Him to do that. Father God, we just lift up to You our brothers and sisters who are going through the most, maybe some difficult times even right now. Remind them of Your faithfulness. Lord, You are faithful to us before. You've watched over us. You are faithful to us now, and You are going to be faithful to us always. Father God, I just pray, God, that You would meet them where they are. Show them Your power. Show them Your glory. Lord, step into the boat with them. And I pray, God, for a miracle right now in the name of Jesus. And we declare, God, that You will show forth Your glory in their life. Healing come. Provision comes. Healing for mental health, come right now in the name of Jesus. Restoration of marriages in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God. It is here and it's available for us because, Lord, You are the one who restores. In fact, You are called the Prince of Peace. You're Shalom. Nothing missing, nothing broken. And You restore us and make us good and make us new. Father, we thank You once again for Your faithfulness and Your steadfast love for Your people. Bless us today, God, once again. Remind us, Lord God, every single day that Your mercies are new every morning. Every time that we wake up in the morning, it's brand new. It's replenished. It's just, it has been restocked. We thank Lord God, Your mercy, Your love, Your faithfulness, they're new every morning. And great is Your love and faithfulness for us, Your people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. Give the Lord praise. Give the Lord praise. Thank You, Lord. Well, thank you so much, Bishop Gilbert, for that powerful word. Can we just give the Lord a hand once again for that word from our dear Bishop Gilbert? You may go ahead and have your seat. And at this point, we'd like to just show you a milestone video of our church in Alabang.
Such a long time ago. And yet it seems some things are still so fresh.
Well, for me, I think to think about 25 years, that's a long time. You kind of forget, you know, the details and to be able to recount the stories of 25 years when it builds faith.
I was part of the QC church plant, diba? So we planted that church with Pastor Manny Carlos, and which is now
Katipunan. So we were helping Pastor Manny, And then I was there just for a year because we were like long time pastors in Victory, Ortigas, or Galleria.
We had two churches in Metro Manila.
You built in Makati Church then.
We did not have any church here in the South at that time.
I think it was in 97. And so Pastor George and Ida started having a heart for Alabang.
We were still in Baguio at the time. Alabang was already dropped sort of in our hearts.
We just said, Lord, we'll just wait for your timing. And the timing came in 1998.
Moved back to Las Piñas.
And then I got a call from Pastor Steve.
And Pastor Steve said that it was time to come back to Manila.
Saying, are you willing to, you know, help out in Alabang? And I said, yeah, of course, wherever we're needed.
We just went for it.
That's when we started, you know, working together, plant the church, community pastor judges. So
it was an adventure, you know. We were going to go there far south, you know. The idea of having a church in Alabang, it was like, wow, it would be a dream come true. We felt like we had to be in the heart of the city. So we started looking for places in the heart of Alabang. I don't remember who gave that idea to go to the mausoleum. Madrigal Art Center.
Yeah, Madrigal Art Center. I don't know if that's still the name there. So
no, it's not. But
Pastor Giorgio said, and Neil said, you know, we're starting a church in Alabang. I remember the Lord spoke to me that night, and he said that Victory Alabang is going to be your church. So I just said, yes, Lord.
And so we looked around, we jumped from place to place. They were still developing the West Gate, but there was this one building. Let's go sign it. Let's just believe God. So we signed the contract, and it was our building. We had the space.
Parang we all had different hats. There's always a door open to help.
At that time, ako pa lang yung the one playing the guitar and leading the worship.
In West Gate, we were starting out with a few families.
The Lord started to speak to us, just disciple the families and the children will come. And so that's what we did. We started to disciple and we were just faithful with the young families that were there. And true enough, their kids started coming to church.
1999.
Yeah. We married and have one child. It was Andy.
Having a safe space growing up, that was very important. These lessons that were taught to me when I was a kid, like around 6 years old in kids' church, the foundation that was set from kids' church before, like it's what's helping me now in real life.
Because we invited Pastor Michael to speak one Sunday through Pastor Michael and Pia.
It's my cousin Pia.
My sister, my wife.
Yeah, they were our missionaries to Russia. They were here on a furlough.
And of course, because their family.
We met up with them, me and Ging. And Pastor Johnson.
Well, we listened to his preaching, which he said.
He said that wasn't his best message.
One of the worst preaching in his life. And then Pastor Johnson got saved.
So we were not Christians then.
I came up and made an altar call.
And then we raised our hands separately. Di namin alam na we both raised our hands pala. And so by that time on, we gave our lives to Jesus Christ. Pastor Jojo and Pastor Jerry, now in Santa Rosa. Sabay kami nun, yung water baptism natin.
Oh, hi everyone! Welcome to Victory Alabang. Allow me to give you a short report on what God is doing in this church.
We came in 2002. We were still in Westgate, and then we were praying for a facility here in Festival Mall. But somehow, the Lord opened the door. And so He led us to the leasing department with this particular lady that was only here until we signed the contract. And then after signing the contract, she disappeared. She kind of like resigned. I'm not sure if she's an angel.
So many memories when we were building, when it was finished.
And so that was great. And so we moved in here.
2003, we were constructing this whole thing. But it wasn't this. It was half of the area that we're occupying now. Remember the red carpet and all beige walls.
Yes, as we were building this, the challenge was our son, Jerome, got sick. We were kind of expecting for a miracle because we were in faith. The church organized like almost like a 40-day prayer chain, you know, like we were fasting, we were believing God for the best. The expectation didn't materialize. It was almost like a bittersweet celebration because we were opening this location in December of 2003.
Yes.
And 2 weeks later, my son died.
It was tough. That was tough for us, for all of us. The whole church, we were praying for Jerome's healing. So we were there for Pastor Ale and Shirley and Bea. And that was such a difficult time for that family.
We were the ones who should be taking care of the flock. And we felt taken care of.
Somebody asked me, how can you recover from grief? First, of course, it's the grace of God. And second, the community, our church family, they helped us recover.
Yeah.
Even if he does not heal Jerome, for us to continue believing God with the church is a miracle in itself.
No matter what happens, God heals. No matter what happens, God is a God of miracles. No matter what happens, God is still faithful to His promise and His word.
If a church is healthy, it will bear fruit.
We saw that it's getting tight. So about 475 people when we came in. The year after, we were about 1,000 plus. And then you add 1,000 every year. And so the need was for us to be able to deploy our pastors because we felt like it's time for us to plant churches.
It was really God preparing the pastoral team and the admin staff for the expansion that was about to happen.
There's a multiplication, there's an expansion. It's yung promise ni God dito eh.
Alabang was able to plant Santa Rosa, Las Piñas, Muntinlupa, Parañaque, now San Pedro. Yeah, an ongoing brewing church, Victory San Pedro.
We're thankful that we're able to plant churches in the south.
From the expansion that happened during that Las Piñas and Parañaque season to the number of services to the pandemic.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just amazing to look back and say, man, how else could this happen if not on God's faithfulness?
But at the same time, one of the things that we are grateful for is also the ability to be able to send out missionaries. And we're continuing to support missionaries abroad. Of course, Neil came from here, Pastor Neil Bernardino, and now he's in San Francisco in the Bay Area. I think Pastor Giorgio is there already in Spain, very open to how God will still use him as a missionary. So one of the health metrics of any congregation or any church is the ability to send out. It's the sending capacity, not the seating capacity. And then we've sent out campus missionaries in the different campuses that we have.
The encounter that I had with God and the relationship that I built with Him before, even up to now, is still something that I could look back at and say, God loves me. And I felt that for the very first time when I was attending the youth services.
Passion and energy inside the youth service really carried out to our schools and even in our families to the point where we'd invite people from our schools, and it would be just fun to see people we know in our school experiencing the same thing we're experiencing.
Like the amount of time and dedication that they would take out of their weekends just so that they could build a relationship with us is really just very admirable, and it still bears fruit up to today.
Pinag-pray talaga natin is yung mga apo-apo. So yun ang nakikita ko for the next generation na nag-rise up talaga.
We came from kids' church with youth. Now we're working. And you're actually married now to Rika, who you were with in kids' church.
Dude, what am I? I'm not sure. No, but I know Rika is a sheep here beside.
It's crazy how God can just connect things and from different seasons and from far, far away places to even calling you out in this moment. You can really see God's faithfulness through that.
That's also how I felt, seeing my old friends, seeing them again.
Santa Rosa is home. In the same way, this is also home. This is where our journey began.
Yeah, it just felt like family. The culture felt like a family. One day. Happy family.
Hindi pa tapos yung expansion ni God.
It's God who built this church, and His hand has been here in the past. However, we cannot get stuck in the past. Our responsibility is to bridge the present to the future. And how do we do that? By celebrating the next generation.
Anniversaries reminds us of God's purpose. that we are to continue to follow Him together as a church, and we are to continue to help others follow Him.
That is impact. It's not so much about us being church-centric. It's about just touching the community. And I think that's who you are, Alabang Church, and continue to do that.
Yours is the greatest story ever told in all of humanity. But after yours, follow all the countless stories that were and still are wave upon waves of testimonies of transformed lives that wrap us in your love and faithfulness. God, today we are humbled. We thank you, God, Holy Spirit, for your presence. We worship you, we praise you. Let the stories that have been shared, being shared, and will continue to be shared later on as we have fellowship, Lord, point everything to you. All these things we ask and declare in Jesus' mighty name. And we say, Amen. Hallelujah! Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat.
Hey, Pastor Jason.
Let me, oh, ayan na pala, si Bodhi.
Nauna na ako.
Okay, I was supposed to call Bodhi. Sasabihin ko sana, I'll call on our pastor, whom we all know is a dashing debonair, pero kinulang si Pastor Bodhi, di ba? Di niya naabutan si Pastor Sunny.
Ayun.
Kulang eh, di ba? Ito si Pastor Bodhi. Si Pastor Sunny nandi dito. Pero let me also say na si Pastor Sunny wala pa sa kalingkingan ni Pastor June Divierte, di ba?
Anong hashtag po ni Pastor June?
Ano?
Hashtag Juniverse.
Juniverse.
No, but kidding aside, Pastor Jansen, seeing that video, I'm just so amazed at the faithfulness of God. I mean, from that, seeing everyone here right now, it's hard for me to imagine that Victory Alabang started with just 30 people gathering in a small and hot mausoleum.
Mausoleum, tama ka.
And they started gathering, studying biblical foundations, and I'm so grateful for that 30. Because you continued to seek God, you continued to obey God, and right now, Pastor Jansen, kita natin yung mga bata na nagki-kids church under the tree are the ones leading us now.
O nga, office mates na natin yung iba.
That's tama true. And the previous generation, we do see them still mentoring. And again, I'm so grateful because apart from that, you know, we see thousands of people who have come to the saving knowledge of Jesus. And I believe that it's really Him who wrote this beautiful narrative for Alabang that is still continuing to unfold.
That is very true, Pastor Bodhi. And just like any classic narrative that starts with a once upon a time, para dito sa atin sa Victory Alabang, once upon a time, there was a couple whose prophetic giftings, their leadership, their vision to believe that the story that the Holy Spirit would write would nothing less be epic. Calling forth things that were not as though they were, they saw when no one saw it then, that Victory Alabang would draw in God's harvest. And this pinpointed exactly the trajectory of this church's future. So Alabang Town Center, the coffee shops, Denbo, the Festival Mall, were prayer houses that started with them, and they were praying with determination, asking God, God, give us the harvest in this place. They were unfazed when Victory Alabang, the church then, meeting in a mausoleum, kids church outside. So may kalye na nga, halos nasa kalye na. But they were unfazed, moving from one location to another, and their faith inked the chapters of the story of Victory Alabang. So please, Victory Alabang Church, please honor with me the church planters of Victory Alabang, Pastor Jojo and Hida Enson. Pastor Jojo, Hida, can you just... please stand up first on your plate, and then we'll call you later on stage. Kaway-kaway sa likod.
Pastor Jojo and Miss Ida, we love you. We're so glad that you're here today to celebrate the 25th. And Pastor Jansen, you mentioned Festival Mall, which we all know is home for us right now. But for those people who joined Victory Alabang in the 2000s, like me, again, it would be interesting to know that we actually moved from one place to another. We started in houses with prayer meetings. Thank you to the leaders who opened up their houses for those prayer meetings. And then eventually, we went to Dad's Restaurant in ATC. Magcha-church ka na, may buffet ka pa. And then Richville Corporate Tower, then Westgate Tower, until God finally brought us to our home in Festival Mall. And Pastor Jansen, I'm so excited to see where God will bring us next.
Yes, that's true, Bodhi. In fact, since the mention mo na yan, di ba, you recall those days, I know we had a sort of like a roll call earlier, but if you started, help plant the church here in Victory Alabang, starting with the Mausoleum days, the Dad's days, Richville Tower, Westgate days, yung bago Festival Mall pa kayo, could you please stand up right now and be recognized? Wow! Remain standing, please. Remain standing. Let me just talk to you. Let me just talk to you. All of you, thank you very much. Thank you for pulling out, so to speak, your pens and papers, putting your hands on the plow, laboring for the church that is today in Alabang. Maraming maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. And with that, Bodhi, I was just reminded, of course, we need to recognize the presence of our very dear Honorable Mayor, Mayor Rafi Biason. By the way, who was part of that group that started Victory Alabang? Nako, lumalabas na yung mga edad natin, Mayor.
And Pastor Jansen, the interesting note about this narrative and story that God has written is that He allowed this church not just to touch this city, but even the neighboring cities. We praise God that He has used this spiritual family to plant several churches around in the area. Pastor Jansen, first church was in Muntinlupa. We started out in the Larishan building. That was led by Pastor June De Vierte and Doc Lisa De Vierte. Maraming maraming salamat po sa inyo. And then afterwards, Pastor Jansen, we have Santa Rosa in Robinsons. That was planted by Pastor Mike Gayataw. I saw him a while ago. Thank you so much. And of course, Santa Rosa afterwards, Pastor Jansen, you led it. And right now, it's being led by Pastor John Naron. So yeah, amazing things. And then after that, we planted Las Piñas in South Mall, led by the original Pastor Sunny Waman and Miss Malu Waman.
Pastor Sunny, sorry na pagkamala ko ng ibang traffic enforcer kanina sa labas. We apologize. We apologize.
And of course, right now, it's being led by Pastor Edric Canda. Thank you so much. And then afterwards, Pastor Jansen, the twin church plants of Paranaque in SM Sukat and SM Bikutan. Of course, led by Pastor Jonathan and Miss Eden back then, and right now being led by Pastor J.R. Sada. Pastor Jonathan, thank you so much. And our newest church plant, Pastor Jansen, San Pedro in the Rocks building.
Pastor King and Phoebe Lucero. Now, if you are, I know tumayo na yung mga pastors natin kanina, but if you are a church planter in those churches, staff, an admin staff, cross-cultural missionary, campus missionary, could you all stand up again, be recognized? We would like to honor you. Palakpakan natin. Church plants of Alabang, Santa Rosa, Muntinlupa, Las Piñas, Paranaque, and San Pedro. Nako, Pastor Bodhi, where to next?
I know, exciting, exciting.
Where to next? Now again, to all the pastor, staff, and campus missionaries of all these church plants, we thank you for willingly, lovingly, selflessly, and sacrificially advancing God's kingdom outside Alabang.
That's true. The kingdom is advancing in our homes, in our offices, in our barangays, And not just that, of course, the kingdom is advancing in the campuses thanks to the hard work and the obedience of our faithful campus missionaries. Pastor Jansen, we have been able to set foot in the campus preaching the gospel in key campuses here in Muntinlupa City. Just some of them, Muntinlupa National High School. A lot of CMs graduated from MNHS, and I think we've had the longest partnership with them the past years. Also, Pamantasan ng Lusod ng Maynila, a lot of professionals that are advancing the kingdom in their offices right now were reached out from PL Moon. Muntinlupa Science High School, the top-notcher RJ Esposo came from there. I hear them there. Campuses like Southville International School, De La Salle Zobel, San Beda Alabang, and so much more. And Pastor Jansen, you know, again, we just like to thank our campus missionaries. And I'd even like to acknowledge the presence of the educators from some of the key campuses from Muntinlupa. If we may just ask you to stand up.
Palakpakan po natin sila. They are our partners. Please continue to open doors for us. You know, the difference with God's story and any ordinary Tom, Dick, and Harry's story is that God's story is always far-reaching, impactful, and it is global. We remember the time that when we had our international student outreach, in between, tanghali pa nga services nila sa Acacia, led by then our campus director, Pastor Edre, who is now the senior pastor of Las Piñas, and he continued this work. And we have one fruit there. One medical student from the University of Perpetual Health College who was raised, discipled, evangelized, raised, discipled, now is raring to go back to his country, yes, to practice medicine, but not just that, potentially to plant a church. Can you imagine that?
Praise God, Julie. God is opening doors. And we also celebrate the way that God has allowed our church to be able to just embrace Matthew 28 to go to the ends of the earth. We celebrate the way that we have been able to send 10 days missioners to 13 nations. Again, 10 days missioners to these 13 nations. Can we just praise God for that? And not just that, Pastor Jansen, we were also able to send a couple of long-term cross-cultural missionaries. I think he's here right now. Doc Demi from Cambodia.
Doc Demi, please stand. Doc Demi, maraming fans club dito si Doc Demi eh.
Of course, to Armenia, we have Merly Jose and Lynn Rodio. Panama, we have Carlo Maranan. Reaching out to our Muslim brothers and sisters, we have Saibel Galano. Brunei, Chalasan was sent there, now in San Pedro. Taiwan, Hero Magno stayed there for a while. And right now in Vietnam, we have Rubelin Garcia. If you happen to be one of our cross-cultural missionaries, can you just stand up so that we could honor you right now?
Pastor Bodhi, we have to add, sa mga, keep on standing, yung mga missionaries natin. If you have gone through any or to any 10 days missions, could you stand up as well? Mga nakapag 10 days dito. 10 days. Wow. They are our missionaries.
And Pastor Jansen, kaya natin sila pinatayo because we are going to invite them. Tama ba?
Tama.
To continue being a blessing to the nation. Pray about it and we'll see where God leads you.
Actually, pinapicture lang kayo ni Pastor Bodhi kaya kailangan namin patayuin yung mga nag 10 days. We're looking forward to seeing you be sent to the nations of the world. Now, in all stories, the book cannot just be folded without honoring the man whom God entrusted to lead us as senior pastor for over 2 decades. God wrote his name and his wife's name for many chapters of Victory Alabang that spanned 21 years. He now serves as our COO and CFO, but gladly, in the national office, but gladly, his feet will continue to stay with us as he serves as one of our pastors. Now he preaches in Acacia. So please give an honorary appreciation to the spiritual father of Victory Alabang during 2 decades, Pastor Ariel and Shirley Marquez. At this point, you know, we would like to give honor to whom honor is due. So we'll be calling on Pastor Jojo and Ida up on stage together with Pastor Ariel and Shirley. Please come up. And at this point, we'll be calling on Bishop Ferdy Kabiling and Bishop Gilbert Folienti as well. No, we'll be, at this point, we'll be asking our bishops first to say a few words for both couples.
Just to let you know, we started off, Jojo and I, in the university belt. And that was the time when he was still a student from La Salle. And we would have trainings for evangelism. We would go to the campuses. So Jojo was assigned to be with me. So we went to Adamson to preach the gospel. While doing that, he was asking me about his love life. And so what a way to talk about love life. You go preach the gospel, you know, on the way, then talk about love life. But it was such an amazing experience. And then after that, when we had one of our students went back to the province, he ended up planting a church. So we couldn't think of anyone who could pastor the church, but it was Jojo who went to the Gupan to first be the pastor there. And then for a while, we started a church again in Baguio, which we're celebrating our 35th. Tomorrow, 35th in Baguio, he was sent to go there and pastor our church in Baguio at some point, and I covered for him sometime. I went there and pastored the church while he was gone. I don't know where you were during that time. You were raising your finances, I think. And then I was single then, so I still remember I was still single then. So that was 33 years ago, something like that. And then he came back again. That was the time when we started our church here in Alabang, and then after that, after his stint of being a senior pastor here, he also helped plant our church in Penang, and came back again, led our prophetic team here with Jim Lafoon here in Manila in the Philippines. Now, you know, he's not stopping. He's helping one of our pastors in Madrid, and at one point, plant a church in Europe. What about that? For an accomplishment, when I grow up, I want to be like you. So I'd like to, is it okay if we're going to just, would it be okay if we're going to just bless him with our prayers and just being grateful to God for his faithfulness and goodness in our lives? And that's one thing that we can, bless a pastor, the Bible says, pray for them. And would you please just stretch out your hands and let's just pray right now for Pastor Jojo and Ida and the new things that the Lord is about to do in their lives. And the Lord is doing a new thing in your life, Jojo and Ida. The pioneering spirit and the prophetic gift that you have put on the table is exhorting and encouraging so many people in all our churches. May you continue to be fruitful in the ministry, in the mission that God has called you to be part of. And at this season in your life, our prayer is that whatever you've done the last 30 plus years, may the Lord multiply it even as you are being sent to other nations, even in Europe at this juncture of your lives. We pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, for your continuous blessings and provision. I thank you, Lord, that churches will be planted, even with Pastor Mel in Madrid. Lord, I pray churches will be planted across, Lord, even Spain and Portugal at this time, at this season, Father God. Lord, I thank you for Pastor Jojo, Lord. Thank you for the pioneering spirit. Thank you for the prophetic gift, Lord God, and with the heart to preach the gospel and do God's mission anywhere, anytime. May it be, Lord God, in Dagupan or Baguio. May it be in Alabang or in Penang. May it be, Lord God, in Spain, even in somewhere in Europe, Lord God. We stand with him. We pray for him. Bless the works of his hands. In Jesus' name we pray, and everybody say,
amen, amen, amen. At this point, we'll ask Pastor Jojo and maybe Ida to say a few words.
Much has been said already. I just want to say thank you for everyone that labored here in the church here in Alabang. We wouldn't make it without you. And to tell you honestly, when we were planting this church, we were clueless. 5 years ago when we were here, I think it was here, we were celebrating our 20th year, Pastor Steve came up to me and he asked me this question. He said, did you ever imagine that the church would be the way it is today? And I told him, no, I never saw it the way it looks today. But really, it's not so much of the numbers that we see. Very impressive. I see thousands of people. But really, what's really impressive is the leaders that were raised up. When I see Nathan leading worship here, wow, that to me is what's all about. It's not so much the numbers. When I see just the leaders and the churches being planted, to me, that's huge. That's big. And so I just want to honor Pastor Ariel when he took the reins of this house. I took it for 4 years, but when he took this church, he really rolled up his sleeves and basically dug deep, and he labored, and there's stories, many stories that's untold, but he really labored in this house. And I just want to honor Ariel for such the work that he's done here and the way it is today. And I just want to honor Ariel. You guys did an excellent job here, and I just want to say thank you so much. And really, this is a testimony of three generations of leaders really taking with me, and now Pastor Ariel, and now Pastor Jansen. And it doesn't stop with Pastor Jansen. Believe it or not, Pastor Jansen, there's always a time we start and we end, and later on, I don't know who's going to take over, and then whoever takes over, there's going to be the next one and the next one. It never ends. We're celebrating 35 tomorrow for Baguio, 25 years today for Alabang. But we will continue celebrating our 30th, our 35th, our 40th, our 50th year. And so God continues to be faithful. It doesn't stop here. So with all that said, I just want to say thank you for the leaders here. Of course, Pastor Ferdy, I just remember when we were very young. I mean, he was there. I just want to love you, Pastor Ferdy. Of course, leader Bishop Man is here. I mean, we wouldn't make it without you guys. It's about relationships. It's about loving the person right in front of you. And so sometimes when you see the bigness of what we see now, it starts with just loving the person right in front of you. And that's basically the power of what we do. We disciple one person at a time and see it grow. So God bless you and congratulations in your 25th year. Thank you so much. You want to say something?
I just want to echo what Jojo said. Thank you, Pastor Ariel and Shirley, for doing such a tremendous job and for humbly taking the baton for 22 years. And also for Pastor Jansen and Ging right now. We know you're going to take it miles and heights. And I'd like also to honor the Lord for giving us the opportunity to plant in His eternal kingdom. And as we saw that Ariel, he has a man already in heaven. Our life here goes beyond. What we are building here is not an earthly kingdom, but the Lord's kingdom that goes beyond. And Jerome is in heaven. My son is in heaven. Another church planter with us, Rino Ke, is in heaven. Adeng Amper, who planted this church with us, they're in heaven. So the world may pass away, but you know, our kingdom, the kingdom of the Lord, will never pass away. So Lord, thank you for that.
Before we're going to pray for Pastor Ariel and Shirley. Before we pray for them, they're two of our closest friends, Pastor Ariel and Shirley. Shirley is like a sister to my wife. Magkamukha sila, pareho pang family name. And then we've worked together. Pastor Ariel, I've worked together for the past 30 years. And we all know, we call Pastor Ariel the party apostle. How many of you know it's fun to be with Pastor Ariel? Always fun. He works so hard, and that's like what Pastor Jojo said. He works so hard, but it's always fun to be with. Pag nasa office yan, naka-scooter yan. I mean, he brings so much fun. Love being with him, love being a friend with him. But one of the things that I I really remember about Pastor Ariel that I think has really connected us more than ever was when his son passed away. I remember Pastor Ariel, we were texting then. My wife was pregnant. We're about to give birth to our second baby. And Pastor Ariel on a Sunday texted, and I thought, I was telling my wife, I can't imagine ever having to bury your own child. I can't imagine how it was be. And they have been just such an example, not knowing that 2 days after that, my own baby would be dead. And it's funny because on that week, nasa pareho kaming cementerio sa morning, it was the cremation of my daughter, and the afternoon, it was their burial of Jerome. But they've served as an inspiration to us of how you continue to worship God in the midst of grief. It's easy to have fun when things are great. It's easy to say God is good when things are great. It's easy to say God is faithful when things are great. But I've seen them say this: God is faithful, God is good, God is great during that time. And that really helped us. So Pastor Ariel, thank you for being a friend. Thank you for being a great leader and being a great example to us. You all know he's a great pastor, but that's Pastor Ariel and Shirley to us.
Now, Pastor Bishop Gilbert will pray for Ariel and Shirley, but let me also say, tomorrow, preaching is about church. Church is about relationships. We see the faithfulness of God through relationships. You know, Pastor Ariel and Shirley, I'd just like to take this quite quick moment lang just to honor you. More than just being office mates, Pastor Ariel and Shirley really raised us up, discipled us, me and my wife. We were not in full-time ministry yet. They met us, pinagtsaga nila kami selflessly, sacrificially, time, resource, lahat na, pati swim bike run, magkasama kami dati. But you know, all these things, it's really just about discipleship. And I just thank God for your lives, the labor and love that you invested. Yes, the church, but even us, me, my wife, Ging, our whole family. We love you dearly, Pastor Ariel and Shirley.
Praise God. Let's pray for Pastor Ariel and Shirley. Can you just reach out your hands to them? Lord, thank you for Pastor Ariel and Shirley. Thank you for they've been faithful shepherds of your people. Lord, thank you for the love that you have filled them with that has overflowed to a lot of different people and different families and has touched their lives. But Lord, thank you for the man and the woman that they are. They're two of the finest Christians, men and women of God, that we can all look up to and learn from and be inspired with. Lord, personally, I thank you for the friendship. Thank you, Lord. You said in your word that there's a friend that sticks closer than a brother, and they are to us, to me and Kathy. And they are to so many people. Lord, with all the ups and downs that they've had in their lives, that they've seen in the church, it's not all up. There's ups and downs, but Lord, we declare your faithfulness is great. You remain loving and good in their lives. And so, Lord, in this transition, and as he takes on more responsibilities, Lord, we're declaring that you are always good, you're always faithful, you're always loving, you're always gracious. And Lord, as they poured out their lives to be a blessing to so many, we're declaring blessings would be upon them, and they will reap a hundredfold of what they've sown in the lives of the people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. At this point, we'd like to hear from you, Pastor Ariel, and maybe Miss Shirley.
Well, thank you so much, Bishop, for that, and Pastor Jansen, Pastor Jojo, and Bishop Ferdy. Thank you so much for entrusting to me and Shirley this particular congregation. back in the day, 21 years ago. This is my first assignment to be a senior pastor. I don't know what to do. It's almost like a Forrest Gump, situation. You know, it's my first assignment to become a senior pastor. I've never preached regularly in my entire life, but I guess I was kind of pushed because there was a need. God called. We responded yes, and you guys are just so easy to love. This church, Alabang, you're so easy to love. Thank you. Thank you for 21 years of being your senior pastor, your spiritual father. But we're still going to be here. We're going to be part of this church. We're still going to be supporting. We're going to cheer on your new senior pastor, Pastor Jansen. And what an amazing testimony that three senior pastors of the same congregation can stand in front of you, honoring God and endorsing one another, and really just building together, because this is really family. We're not perfect. We don't get along all the time, but we can have disagreements, yet at the end of the day, we're stuck together. We're family. And we're going to move on forward until we see Jesus returns in all his glory. Amen. And you know, we're celebrating 21 years, 25 years. I just want to just share this short exhortation for us. You know, in Psalm 9:1, it says, I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart. I will recount all your wonderful deeds. And, you know, you've seen just a portion of what God has done through that video. And there's a lot more. And you have your own story to tell. But it's important to remember how we started, because, you know, we cannot separate ourselves from the past, because that basically helps us to live our present. And it guides us for our future. And if there's one thing that we don't want to miss out or lose in this church, is the honor of God. We will continue to honor God in everything that we do. Amen. Honoring God in our past releases God's blessings into our future. We will do that. We've done that in the past. It's all about God's glory and God's honor. We've done that then. We are doing it today. We will continue to do that in the future. Amen. God's name is to be honored and to be glorified. Can we just give the Lord a hand for that? Remember God's faithfulness to us. And if I may just leave you a scripture, you know, I was reminded of Joshua after he was distributing the land already, after they conquered so many lands. In Joshua chapter 13, verse 1, it says, when Joshua was old, now I'm not that old, okay? But this is the scripture. When Joshua was old and well advanced in years, the Lord said to him, you are very old and there are still very large areas of land to be taken over. You know, we may have turned over the baton to your new senior pastor. Yes, we have planted several churches. We have sent out missionaries outside. But how many of you know that there are more lands to be conquered? Amen. There is more. Tell the person beside you, there is more. Tell the person to your right, there is more. Tap the person in front of you and say to that person, there is more. There is more to conquer. There is more to believe in. There is more, because I believe there are more lands to conquer. There are more souls to be saved. And I'm asking you, continue to remain faithful to God. And my last scripture for us is this. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20 and 21. God is able to do more. It's not about us. It's about God himself. There is more land to conquer, but God is able to help us do more. Now to him who is able to do more, far more abundantly than all we ask or think, according to the power at work within us, to him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Keep the faith, guys. Keep making disciples. Keep sowing seeds. Keep honoring God. There is more, and I believe that God will do it. Amen. I also want to thank my wife, Shirley, for the past 21 years, for standing with me, believing with me. In fact, when Pastor Steve was the one who called us, I was hesitant to come. But this lady said, let's go. Let's not wait anymore. God's calling us to Alabang. What are you waiting for? And so we came, we went by faith. We're here. And I want to thank you for standing with me. for the past 21 years, believing with me, believing for a miracle, despite what we've gone through as a family, you have been there with us, and you have actually helped disciple even the young wives in this church. So thank you, Lau. Thank you. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for being with me. Love ya. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Say, there's more. We'll give you a picture of more. When we say more, it's more souls in the campus, more souls won for God in the community. Amen? We'll give you a picture of what that is through our next video. Let's watch.
In 2017, Love the City was born. It was an initiative for us, the church, to go out and be a blessing to our city as God has called us to be. We started out by giving Christmas Noche Buena bags and even relief goods during natural calamities. This year, we blessed the city of Muntinlupa, not just with goods, but with our service. Last September, 20 of our lawyers and legal practitioners came together to offer free legal counsel to the people of Barangay Poblacion and Barangay Tunasan. We served over 50 Muntinlupeños by offering them legal advice for their tough situations, giving them a prayer of hope, and even preaching the gospel to them. 2 weeks later, 40 doctors, dentists, nurses, and other medical practitioners came together for the first ever medical and dental mission in the city since the pandemic. 367 people went through physical checkups, x-rays, skin consults, dental cleaning, tooth extractions, and thanks to your generosity, they even received free vitamins and medicines. Our prayer team was also there to minister and to preach the gospel. We praise God for these opportunities to bless the city and for opening doors to partner with our government officials in the advancement of God's kingdom.
Nagpapasalamat po tayo sa Panginoon dahil ginamit po ang Victory Alabang para maging blessing sa maraming tao, lalong-lalo na po sa mga kabarangay namin sa Barangay Poblacion. At patuloy po tayong manalangin para sa bawat isa. Maraming salamat po.
Dito na po magsisimula yung magandang sama ng Victory Church at ng Barangay Tunasan. Kaya muli, maraming salamat.
Nandito po kami ngayon sa City Hall para tanggapin mula po sa Victory Christian Fellowship ang donation na patient transport vehicle. Ito po ay magagamit ng aming bagong tatag na bahay kandungan. Ang bahay kandungan po ay ang tinatawag nga nating shelter ng mga abandoned elders. Ito po yung mga seniors na wala na hong nag-aalaga sa kanila.
At tungtuwa po talaga kami dahil binigyan mo niyo po kami ng napakalaking blessing para sa aming bahay kandungan. Tunay nga po kayo ay instrument ni God. Ang blessings nga ng Panginoon ay talagang in His time. Maraming salamat po.
You have been a blessing to Muntinlupa City, and I am believing that you too will be blessed by God with what the church has done. So maraming salamat po sa ngalan ng mga Muntinlupeño. God bless you all.
Now this partnership with the City of Muntinlupa is a testament that we do things in a socially responsible way. And this is made possible by God's provision through you. So yes, we thank God for this, and we thank you for your generosity. This means that we live out what we preach, and you do what you read, study, and meditate coming from the Bible. Now, all for the glory of God. As the Bible says in 1 Peter 4:11, that in all things, God may be glorified.
We've heard many wonderful stories, and these men and their wives who were sharing their heart, I really want to commend them. They're genuine shepherds. You know, a pastor is a shepherd. And from Pastor Jojo and Ida, Pastor Ariel and Shirley, Pastor Jansen and Ging, even Bishop Gilbert, Bishop Ferdy, all these men and their wives, I've walked with these men for many years. And they're just people who really love God's people. And that's why you sense somehow that perhaps being in this spiritual community, that God is really present here. So I want to commend them. Let's give them another round of applause.
I want to say a couple of things because I came in. I had to come from Victory Katipunan. I was also teaching there in prayer. And Lord, what do I give as an encouragement for the church? And I didn't really have a clarity until I actually stepped into this room. And I'll tell you what it is in a moment. But let me say this first, okay? As Pastor Johnson was making an allusion, or who was it, Pastor or Bishop Gilbert even, this is a story of God's people birthed and into the kingdom of God. No? And stories are very important. And so obviously, Victory Alabang, there's a story to it, and you're part of that story. But can I say this, because I've spoken many times in church anniversaries, and every time I say this, then it makes it real what the story is really all about. See, Victory Alabang, yes, it's 25 years old, and next year, Victory is going to celebrate 40 years. That's going to be such a milestone for our ministry. But can I say this to the pastors and to all of the leaders and to all of you? Victory Alabang is not 25 years old. It's 2,000 years old. This church, Jesus said, I will build my church and the gates of Hades will not prevail. The reason this church is going to go the distance with us, through us, our children, is because Jesus is the founder of this church. So, obviously, we can say 25 years. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm just saying it's much older, okay? Because we have a righteous King who shed His blood for us to be redeemed and become a community of people. Now, having said that, this is what the Lord really impressed upon me. I bounced it off with Pastor Oriel. I want to articulate it, then we'll pray. If there's one thing that's clear about this church, there's a Davidic anointing on you as a congregation. When I came in here, we're in a tent. And it just reminded me of the time when David wanted to bring back the Ark of the Covenant after Saul had died. He wanted to bring back the presence of God, and he put the Ark of the Covenant in a tent. And of course, from that time on, his kingdom expanded, he became king, and what happened was, he was, in 2 Samuel, he says, Lord, here I am in a palace of cedar while the house of God remained in a tent. And so Nathan told him, do what's in your heart. And the Lord appeared to Nathan and told him, tell David this, I have not dwelt in a house ever since I came with you out of Egypt. And to this day, okay? And to this day, that's where I've been. What is it about a tent that is so important? See, God goes with His people, but not only that, God is still on the move. Now, having a desire, I don't know, I haven't talked to maybe I've had a conversation. I'm hesitant to prophesy it, but maybe I'll say it as a statement of faith. I believe God wants to give you your own property in this city. He's done that in U-Belt. He's done that in Katipunan. He's done that in Santa Rosa. How many of you know we have the same God? Okay, now, Alabang properties, I know, are some of the highest in Metro Manila. So, how many of you know, nothing's impossible with God? Hallelujah. Okay, so, but in my heart, I think, so as I said, mahirap mag-prophesy kasi pag, Lord, sa'yo ba to? I'm just saying nothing's impossible with God, okay? Amen. But what's more important is this. more than the house, it is the desire for God to dwell amongst His people. And the Lord wants you to know as a church that the Davidic anointing is on you, in your leadership, in your church. And one of the hallmarks of you as a congregation is the presence of God is going to be very tangible whenever you gather together. And the Lord wants you to know as a church that just like David would play the harp and the demons would leave Saul, so it is, so the Lord says you will have an anointing that people who are coming out from the world and they enter into your services and they're oppressed by spiritual, by all kinds of spiritual oppression. The Lord says they will be delivered even from depression. They'll be delivered even from a place of sadness and even suicide. You're going to see people set free by the worship that's in this church. Not only that, the Lord, just like David became king, there's an anointing on this church to raise leaders in the kingly sphere, in government, in business, in education. The Lord wants you to know that there is going to be a favor on you to raise up leaders. And it is not a coincidence that Mayor Ruffy is here. Just by the way, I don't know if you realize this, 3 of the city mayors of Metro Manila all go to Victory now. We have Mayor Vico in Pasig, we have Mayor Ruffy, and we have Mayor Lani Cayetano in Taguig. God wants you to know there's a grace on us as a ministry to raise leaders who will rule in righteousness and the fear of God. Come on. And lastly, the Lord told David, you're not going to be the one to build a house. It's going to be your son Solomon. And what I sense really is this, and let me add this by the way, that Davidic anointing, I feel, I told this to Pastor Ariel, I realize this church has produced so many of our worship leaders from, of course, Pastor Saul and Lucci, from Quest, from Barbie, who else? Meron ka pa binanggit eh. Barbie, there's even Kitschy, and even in the secular field, the Lord's going to raise up, okay? If you're going to be in the music scene, come on, you'd be based here. Anyway, may natira naman sa Katipunan, okay? Pero, buwan dito na nang dinala ni Lord lahat. You're going to have an anointing to bring in the music scene of this city, of this nation. There's going to be an anointing and people will be drawn to Christ because of that. And finally, number 3, the Lord said, you're not going to build a tent, your son Solomon. And the Solomon means the peace of God. And I want to know something. The extent of, if you look at the reign of David and Solomon, that was the greatest extent of the expansion, if you will, of the kingdom of Israel. And there was one thing that marked the leadership of Solomon, and I believe that grace is on you as a people, and that is wisdom. And I want to just release that. Would you all just stand up right now? Lord, I thank you for this congregation. Lord, thank you that we're part of a bigger family called Victory. And every one of us have the same mantle for making disciples, for raising leaders, for doing social responsibility. Thank you, Lord, that that's true for us all across this city. But yet, this ministry is going to be known for that Davidic anointing, people being healed and set free just by the presence of God as they worship. But not only that, they're going to raise leaders in government, leaders in the marketplace, who are going to be men and women of wisdom. And so, Lord, pour out the spirit of wisdom upon this congregation. Bring promotion to them wherever they are. Let the next 25 years be marked by great expansion and favor and goodness. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Remain standing. We'll pray for our dear mayor. Mayor, could you just come up front here?
Why don't we just stretch out our hands to Mayor Ruffy? Lord, we thank you so much for this man that you have appointed to lead this city that we are in. And thank you that you're even reminding him right now that the power and the influence that he has, those are things that he has, not because he wanted it for himself, not because the people around him wanted it for him, but Lord, you were the one who entrusted these things to him because you have a purpose. I pray, Lord God, that you continue to just anoint him with wisdom. Thank you for the humility that you have placed in his heart, a heart that just says, Lord, I want to honor you. And Lord, I thank you for the spirit of excellence. Thank you that you are reminding him that you have appointed him to lead the city, not just so that he could bring innovation and bring excellence and bring wonderful changes, but Lord, you have allowed him to lead the city so that he may be able to bring the gospel to this city, O Lord God. I thank you that you would be the one to open doors for him, for his life to be used to glorify you. And once again, Lord God, I thank you. I speak an increase in anointing. I speak an increase when it comes to wisdom. I speak an increase when it comes to influence, when it comes to compassion. Thank you, Lord God, that Muntinlupa, under his leadership, would rise up to be a model city. And when people, when the other cities look to this city, oh Lord God, they would acknowledge that this has not been the work of man, but truly this is the work of God. Thank you that you will bless the work of his hands, O Lord God, so that he may glorify you. And I thank you that you are even reminding him right now that you will not only use him to open doors for the church and for other believers to raise the next generation, but you are opening the doors for him himself to raise a new generation of government officials who will continue to serve and lead with integrity, all for your glory. Continue to protect this man. Bless everything that he does. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Lord, thank you for, you said in your word in Romans chapter 13 that your civil servants are servants of God. They are ministers of God. For the Lord would say unto you, my son, that I have chosen you and I have appointed you for such a time as this, says the Lord. And you're going to be my minister, not just a public servant, but a minister of God. I'm going to minister to you first, to your family, says the Lord. There's going to be a fresh visitation of my spirit that's coming upon you, says the Lord. There's going to be a new hunger like never before. You will wake up in the middle of the night and you will want to read the word. And there will be times that you wouldn't know what to do and you will cry out to me in prayer, says the Lord. The Lord says, you will be literally my minister. You will bring forth my word. Not in a way that a preacher or a full-time pastor would do it, but in your own way, in the own way that I've wired you and gifted you, says the Lord. And do not worry, my son, because I have raised up, just like Elijah, there are 7,000 more prophets that I've raised up and preserved. There are men and women of God, some of them Christians, some not, but I have used them and I will use them for my purpose. And they are with you, says the Lord. I've raised up prayer shields and prayer warriors. I would rise up and run with the vision that I've given you for this city, says the Lord. So continue to minister before me. As you minister to them, I will minister and fill you up every day, says the Lord. Amen.
All right, as we prepare to worship, allow me just to make some declarations. You know, we're looking back. We're looking back, but not just for nostalgic reasons. You know, the author of Hebrews 13 was exhorting the church to look back, look at the ones who have gone ahead of them, look at their life and imitate their faith. And we can do that as a church because he said, because Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And I was telling Bishop Manny a while ago, the word that he shared is exactly the same word that I will declare to you. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So when we look at our past, we will see that yes, we're celebrating 25 years, but we go all the way back to the very foundation of the church, which is the cross of Jesus Christ. And this is the gospel that we proclaim. Amen. We look back and we will see that we have the same God yesterday, today, and forever, and we have the same mission. Amen? So could you say this with me? God is faithful. God has been faithful for the last 25 years, and we have reached the campuses. But just as Pastor Ariel said, we will continue to claim the harvest in every campus in Muntinlupa City in the next 25 years. Amen? God is faithful. Come on, one more time. God is faithful. God is faithful. And we will bring the church to every nook and corner in this 40 square kilometer city. And we will spread the gospel in all possible locations that God will bring us to. Amen? God is faithful. God is faithful. God is faithful. God, He has been faithful for the last 25 years. And we have reached, raised, discipled students, teenagers, single, married men and women who brought the gospel to every sector in society. And in the next 25 years, we will continue to raise children, teenagers, single men and women, married men and women, and they will bring the gospel to every sector in society, in the government, in the arts, in the sciences, in the business, in the marketplace. Amen. God is faithful. God is faithful. For the last 25 years, we've planted churches and we've sent cross-cultural missionaries, and we will continue to do so as we look forward to the next 25 years. God is faithful. God is faithful. God is faithful. When this church was planted, we've asked God for musicians, but not just for plain and simple music. We will, in the next 25 years, starting with the album that we are releasing now, we will compose, we will produce, and we will release music that will declare the gospel and the glory of God to the nations of the world. Amen? God, You are faithful. You are good all the time. You are great, marvelous, and You are the author of our story. So God, we bring back all the glory and praises to You. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
This is off script, okay? We're flowing in the Spirit. I just want to honor Pastor Jansen. You are in good hands with this new senior pastor. He's a man of the house. He was a son of the house. He was born and raised here. I've seen his life, and I can commend him to you with all confidence. I've seen the way he treats his wife, the way he raised up his kids. He is someone that God has entrusted this church, and he will take this church on to the next 25 years and beyond. Amen. He is a great leader. We've seen his wisdom. If there's a faithful man, the Bible says, a faithful man who can find, he will serve before kings. God's looking for faithful men. God is faithful, yes, but he's also looking for faithful men. Guess what? He found a faithful man in Jansen Morados. Pastor Jansen, you are a fine leader. You will take on this church to the next 25 years and beyond. Amen. God bless you. Follow his lead. Praise God. Come on, let's worship the Lord.
Let's worship God.
Thank you, Lord. Let the gospel alive within us.
Let the gospel alive within us. Shake our city.
Shake the nations.
Shake the nations. Send us as one.
With you, we're gonna sing it again.
Because we're getting ready for what you will do. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for each and everyone you have gathered. Thank you for your faithfulness. And Lord, as Lamentation 3:24 says, Lord, you are our portion. Therefore, we have hope. Therefore, we look forward to a future where God's goodness, faithfulness is expressed forevermore. Let's praise this God. We thank you. We praise you, Jesus. In your name we pray. Amen and amen and amen.
Praise God. So much to thank God for, Pastor JJ. So much to celebrate. I know it feels like we're winding down, but wait, there is more. We'd like to ask you to take your seats as Pastor JJ and I share a couple of new things that is happening in Victory Alabang in the next couple of months.
I just love the fact that we get to celebrate together. And you have heard it said, si Pastor Jansen, nabanggit niya na to. You have sung the songs of this community. Songs that are written by our very own men and women within this house. So, we're releasing that song, Then, Now, Always. That song is now in YouTube through a lyric video. And then tonight, Pastor Bodhi, it'll be out in Spotify. We're praying that more songs. Say tayo, palakpakan natin si Lord. We're praying that more songs would be written, not only for anybody, really, but for the glory of God.
That's and right, Pastor JJ. It's really amazing. From the very beginning, I've heard the stories of our leaders. God has blessed this church with the gift of worship.
Yeah.
And we are just so grateful that He birthed Victory Alabang Music this year, our 25th again, so that we could proclaim the gospel in song to the nations. And we have heard a lot of wonderful stories. I'm sure if we will tell all the stories, it's going to last more than 3 hours. But we do have a very special announcement for each and everyone. What I'm carrying right now, Pastor JJ, we can't tell all of the stories tonight, but we do have a book coming up, really just chronicling the history of Victory Alabang. So we call it Then, Now, Always. It's a coffee table book that we are going to release very, very soon. And Pastor JJ, we only printed 400 copies. So you see the QR code up on the screen. You can actually take a photo or a screenshot of that right now so that you can pre-order this book. Truly a lot of stories about God's faithfulness through this church and in the lives of the people here.
We're celebrating God and what He has been doing. And in fact, we're not only celebrating it through stories, through the songs, we're also celebrating God in your lives. That's why we want to honor you. Palakpakan man natin si Lord. Sa ating mga leaders, volunteers, you are the church. We are the church. Kaya nga, we want to honor you. We want to celebrate you through a simple gift. This card that we're giving you is our then now always 25 years of Victory Alabang. It's a thank you from all of us. We have partnered with several establishments, Pastor Bodhi.
Yes, one of the things that we value is relationship, and that happens through Victory Groups doing one-to-one. So we partnered with several establishments in PhilInvest and beyond so that this card would give us discounts every time we meet together in our groups. Our partners are being flashed on screen, and right now our ushers are actually giving everyone in this tent this commemorative card so that we could enjoy more fellowship time together.
May food, Pastor Bodhi, tas may gym din.
Meron ding gym, okay. Merong food, merong coffee shops. It's just really an exciting time, so why don't we just allow our ushers to distribute that right now. And Pastor JJ, again, so much to celebrate, so much to thank God for.
And really, God has been faithful. God is faithful. God will always be faithful. And part of that story is that He's growing our church. Nararamdaman niyo ba yun? The Church of Christ is continuously growing. Kaya nga, one exciting announcement is that starting next week, we will be opening a new service. Our 7 p.m. service in Festival Mall to be led by none other than Pastor Bodhi Cruz.
So, let's continue to worship God together. That means more seats in the services. We can reach out to more people. We will not stop until our family and friends and even everyone here in Muntinlupa is lifting up their hands to worship God. And of course, you said I'll be leading the 7 p.m. service. My good friend and one of the people that I look up to, Pastor JJ, will take over the 5 p.m. service.
Excited to continue worshiping and growing and serving the Lord with all of you. Pastor Bodhi?
Yes, and please do not leave after this. You know that we have food, fun, and fellowship outside. We do have Baga, Manila. If you have your tickets, you can use the stubs there to buy your food. And we'd really love just to hang out with you and catch up with you. Talk about the stories, the past 25 years, and talk about the stories that are happening in our lives right now. And if you will post photos, kindly use our official hashtag, hashtag 25 years of Victory Alabang.
Now to commission us as we go forth and make disciples, let me call on our senior pastor, Pastor Jansen Marados.
Let's all stand. Matthew 28. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ has commanded. And as He promised, He will be with you to the very ends of the age. Amen. Amen. Let's worship.
All of the days of my life.
And we sing with me, we say, God is good,
God is good,
all the time,
all the time.
We're gonna bring it back. We're gonna take it back. Tabi niyo muna yung mga arthritis niyo. Can we just celebrate? All the way to the back. We're gonna celebrate the goodness of God. Come on, hey!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
in what you have done the past 25 years. We are rejoicing with what you are doing in and through this church right now. And Lord, we will continue to rejoice because we know that you will open more doors for this church to glorify you in this city. Lord, continue to empower each and every one of us to be a blessing, to glorify you in every way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Happy anniversary, everyone. God bless you.